First T20I, England won by 47 runs. Second T20I, England yet again win by 47 runs. 2-0 England in the 5-match series. Here we look at the second T20I on Avneer Presents, The Outside View, powered by WTF Sports. So let's move to the talking points. The first one being West Indies bowlers' discipline at the start. They really didn't let the English openers or the English middle order batters set in and score as fast as they did in the first T20I. But towards the end, things went wrong. So, Ananya, how impressed were you with West Indies' pace bowlers at the start?
Well, I was really impressed with them. The fact that, you know, they came out with a plan, they came out with some energy. And they really looked like they knew what they were doing. It wasn't like they were just dishing out half volleys or allowing, you know, the openers to come at them. So it was really impressive. But I think more than the pacers up front, it was Stefani Taylor who kind of really controlled the middle of the innings. She was really good, not just with her bowling, but with her field set. Those first 15 overs were brilliant. And the way she used her arm ball to really good effect on a surface that, you know, really helped her. I thought that was the standout of the first 15 overs. But like you said, they kind of just allowed it to slip away really quickly towards the end.
Today, we saw two types of West Indies. The one which had control for the first 15 overs. And then for the last 5 overs, they really lost the plot. 40 runs in the last 3 overs, that's where they probably lost the match.
Yeah, I know. And I think it was the last couple of overs where, especially the over from Cornell, where she kind of, it didn't appear like she had a plan. She was bowling short with her field and very wide. And like her field didn't seem to match what she wanted to do. And there was just so much uncertainty around those plans, which meant that they leaked far too many runs. And yeah, it was just a case of West Indies kind of, I suppose, just relinquishing their grip on the game at that point.
Credit also has to be given perhaps to Sarah Glenn-Snock and her stand with Catherine Brunt. That really changed the face of the game.
Yeah, it did. I think they were really sensible with the way they went about that partnership. They, at least Sarah Glenn really played the field really well. She was hitting the ball where there weren't any fielders, which is essentially what, you know, batters have to do. And the fact that she was, you know, aware of the field and aware of how to find those gaps was very impressive. So, yeah, that was a big positive for England in the batting.
Moving on, West Indies, for them to do well, the trio of Hayley Matthews, Deandra Drottin, as well as Stefani Taylor need to fire in unison. Drottin and Taylor had got a good start, good partnership, but just at the time when they had to sort of explode, they imploded.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's what happens when you rely so heavily on just three batters. I mean, it means that all three of them have to essentially set a base and then also explode, which is really difficult when you think about it. I mean, the fact that there's so much reliance on them, I thought, you know, the approach, like you said, from Stefani Taylor and Deandra Drottin was much better today. They were looking to rotate strike, which was great.
As the match was coming towards the end, I was sort of comparing whether a glass is brittle or the West Indies middle and lower middle order. 7 for 24, that's pretty much too much in a one day, let alone a T20 game.
Yeah, it is. But I think when you look at the order and it just looks like they're unsure of who to send where. I mean, you think of someone like Brittany Cooper, who was a standout performer 4 years ago for them, who is languishing so low down. And then Shemaine Campbell, who's essentially not a power hitter, but batting at number 6-7, where you expect power. So I think they're just a little muddled with their order. And that's something that they really need to look into if they want to win, because like you said, it's far too brittle at the minute.
Moving on to our yay or nay moments. So what are your choices today?
So once again, my yay moment will be, you know, the a bowler again. So Stefani Taylor's arm balls that were really, really impressive. And as far as nay goes, I think while the ground fielding was exceptional today from both sides, it's the catching was just horrendous. And so many catches shelled. I was really surprised. What about you? What did you pick today?
Sarah Glenn's batting, actually, because we know she can bat, but to change the complexion of the game was really admirable. And the name movement would be something that you talked about. West Indies middle order, very confusing about what they want to do with their players. So that's really the name movement for me. So that's it from us this time. Keep watching Avneel Presents The Outside View, powered by WTF Sports.